By these treacherous demons of the imagination.
And when you're safe inside, you're afraid to take a drink.
Because a deadly virus may be in the water. So hide back in the farthest corner of the couch and turn on the TV.
And after an evening's imaginative stroll with terror, it'll be nice to see something soothing to your nerves. Something like my tale of terror tonight. Now that the Black Widow is no longer making Gooseby paranoid, and the twins are having such a joyous romp through the state of Connecticut, maybe now I can have my typo cocktail. So much fun. And the giant spider reminded me of a graveyard rhyme. Thank you, Chair. Little Miss Muffet sat on a tuffet, eating her currants and whey, when along came a spider and sat down beside her. Bit her on the seat, took the food, and began to eat. George, that's not the way it goes. Oh, it went real fine when you did here. You got to the bottom of the issue.
That was real good, George.
Oh, you're glad someone appreciates your talents, George.
But I have a better rhyme.
Oh, go, you do. What is it?
Mary, Mary, quite contrary.
Oh, I like contrary people. Yes, George, they're so irascible.
Shut up, so I can continue.
Oh, I'm very sorry, Skull. George is sorry, too.
I'm sorry I ever started.
Yes, George, we'll be quiet.
Don't bet on it. Mary, Mary, quite contrary, how does your garden grow with broken skulls and decaying bones all laid out in a row?
What skull? That would be perfect for spring planting.
As far as being a legend is concerned, I'm not really sure that that's true yet.
Oh, it's true.
Everybody says it is, and I'm very grateful. I think God has blessed me. But I knew that he was going to last for a while when the 13-week sponsor contract ran out. That sponsor went bankrupt, and other people picked it up and continued the show. And it's one of the longest running 13-week contracts in the history of television. Because I was on the air for, around 30 years still.
The cemetery. So peaceful and quiet. The tombstones, so neat and grotesque in the night, with their shadows and threatening shapes, just perfect to give you a fright. But what is better is when the world has gone to rest, the spirits, ever so slowly, come up out of the ground. And when they have risen through those six deadly feet of earth, they're released from their tombs and free to roam.
Perhaps they're coming to your home to make things go bump in the night. Or maybe they're out on the town. There isn't any law that says ghosts can't jive in a dive. But all too soon, the moon sinks in the western sky, and the light of day is on its way. This means the spirits of the city of eternal rest must return to their earthen homes, back down into the crusty soil, past the tunnels and mazes of ants and worms, beyond the depths of the mole and weasel, into the inky blackness of clay and rock, where the vicissitudes of life on earth go past without a shake or shock. But on another night, when the moon is full, the ghosts will once again rise for a night-long stroll. Not all such places are graveyards of horror. Death in some is a real howl. After all of that, are you sure you'll be able to sleep the rest of this night? I doubt it. And next Friday night, you'll be even more perplexed and frightened when you see my tale of terror. A favorite camp event is to gather around the campfire when the sun has long set. And with the wind rustling the leaves, the occasional buzzing of an insect in your ear, you tell ghost stories. And later, lying in your sleeping bag, you're frightened beyond belief. Well, next Friday night, my horror story will eclipse all of the narratives you have heard around your campfire. For you will be launched into a cataclysmic experience of terror! Until we meet again, many pleasant nightmares. Ha 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 ha